room, you know. I think any girl would be incredibly flattered, in all honesty. And you know, as a kid, I remember it was actually really funny. I was doing the sheet, and I was working with Danilo, who's a fabulous hairdresser, and we were doing the shoot, and he was using the products on me, and I remember the smell so reminds me of being a little girl, and my mom washing my hair on a Sunday night, you know, before school started on Monday morning. And I distinctly remember like sitting in the lounge and she'd be drying my hair, and it was that smell, the smell brought it back. I always take my makeup off before I go to bed, always, always, always. And if I'm not working, I don't wear makeup. Because so often I've got makeup on all day and the hot lights, and it's quite nice to give my skin a break, really. So no, I'm very, very, very low maintenance. I very rarely get manicures or pedicures, but if I get my nails done, I just get them buffed, and I have my eyebrows done and I have my eyelashes tinted, and I always get my hair done. But aside from that, no, because then everything else just kind of takes care of everything else, you know. My mom always encouraged me to choose my own clothes and go for my own thing, and she'd always kind of encourage me to have an opinion about stuff as well. So she'd turn around and go, okay, why do you like that? Why do you like that spotty dress with the thing? And normally when I was a little girl, it would be to do with how spinny it was. You know, when you're a little girl and you always kind of do the spin test, and if it's a really spinny dress, it's really good. But to me, it's just really personal. It's an expression of all the different facets of your personality. And on some days I'm kind of one thing, ladylike and feminine, and on another day I'm kind of rock chick and something else. And I think it's an expression of your own individuality. I don't have a stylist, I style myself, because I think that there is quite a big difference between European style and American style. And I've tried different stylists and I've tried working with different people, and in the end, I think it's so personal. So say for instance, if you're meeting your business manager, you might wear one thing. If you're going out for cocktails with your girls, you'll wear something else. If you're meeting your boyfriend's mother for the first time, you'd wear something else. And it just depends on what you've got to do for the day. I'm not very interested in doing a designer look from head to toe. I think that's kind of a little bit boring, in all honesty. So I think it's about taking inspiration, and particularly with vintage for me, it's like finding treasure. And then you take it and you kind of make it modern, or you change the hem or change the straps or put a belt around it, and it's making it then modern for every day. Yeah. I love Matthew Williamson, I love Isabel Marant, she's my new favourite. I always say that Matthew's like the fairy godmother that every girl needs. You know, he supplies a fabulous frock and then he tells you not to be home at midnight. Do you know what I mean? His clothes can take you anywhere, from kind of presenting at the Brit Awards to changing Kasabian's guitars to dancing until dawn. And that's what's great about his
clothes. So have you ever done that thing, one of his frocks?
Yes. Yes, that was absolutely what it was. You could tell by my knowledge, couldn't you? It was like, yeah, Brit Awards, changing guitars for Kasabian, dancing till dawn. Check, check and check. Quite often for work I have to dress up, and it's absolutely part of, you know, it's a part of it that I love, and I really enjoy that aspect of my life. But also sometimes it's really nice to just kind of throw a t-shirt dress on and a pair of sandals and just head out. New York and London are very, very similar, and you know, it's all about the shoes and the put togetherness, and it's like, but in LA it's a lot more relaxed, and it's, you know, you drive a lot, so, and you can basically walk around wearing anything in LA and nobody even pays the slightest bit of notice. Do you know what I mean? There are people that walk around with face guards on with bruised eyes from the latest nose job, and nobody even looks twice, so you can just walk around in whatever you like. I think they all think I'm a slightly bonkers English eccentric, and I know that sometimes I come out and I walk out onto the show and they're like, what the hell is she wearing? And they just don't get it at all. But nobody's ever said, oh, you should do this or you should do that or look more this way, or I haven't felt the pressure at all, to be honest with you. I know that some people do, but I just haven't. I miss Topshop so much. I miss Topshop and French Connection and Whistles and miss Selfridge, you know, and whenever I come back, I'm literally like, right, I'm going for a Hoover along the high street, literally kind of gathering everything up. But I love the vintage shopping in LA. it's amazing. It's so, and it's so much cheaper than London, and there seems to be so much more available too. I've got a pool, so I swim. But it's much easier in LA because it's sunshine and palm trees, and it's much easier than being here. But you know, in the winter time when it gets dark at 3:30 and it's freezing cold, and all you want to do is drink a glass of red wine and have sausage and mash. Do you know what I mean? It's much easier to be healthier there. As you can see, I fully move. I think it would be very weird if all of a sudden everybody turned up. If I ended up talking like that all the time, I think people have really noticed, because I'm so kind of, I talk a lot with my face and with my expressions and stuff, so I think it would be very, very obvious. I actually find the traveling really, really difficult because I'm not a great sleeper. So for me, it's not the actual traveling itself. I've got that kind of down to a fine art now. I've got, you know, going through security, I can do it in approximately 45 seconds flat because I'm so used to it by now. But the sleeping and the jet lag is just atrocious. And I've tried everything from having, you know, one drink on a flight to having no drinks on a flight to drinking like three bottles of water and melatonin and Ambien, and I've tried the works and nothing helps. I always end up feeling kind of not great at the end of the day, but I've got little things that I take with me, like I always take a pashmina with me, and tiger balm I always take with me, loads and loads of moisturizer, face spritzing spray, and also I've got this spray called Butter's Nose, and it's like meant to be very calming and very kind of soothing and all the rest of it. So listen, I try anything.